Let us discuss the behavior of L and C at high and low frequency alternating current. Say we just talk about an inductor first. We know that for an inductor its ohmic opposition is inductive reactance, which is written as omega L. Here we can directly say for high frequency, if we just analyze, the value of XL will be high because it is proportional to omega. And similarly, if we talk for low frequency, the value of XL is very low. And if we calculate at very high frequencies, then we can directly state at very high frequencies, the value of XL will be so high that this inductor will behave like an open circuit. Similarly, at a very low frequency of variation, or we can talk approximately at DC values where there is almost no variation in direction of current, you can see the value of omega will be very low, negligible, so value of XL will also be negligible. This inductor will behave like a short circuit, which we already discussed in case of DC. In a steady state, an inductor behaves almost like a straight wire. Similarly, if we talk about a capacitor, then we can state for a capacitor, its capacitive reactance is written as XC, which is 1 by omega C. So, if we calculate for high frequencies, you can see the value of XC will be low, because as omega is high, as it is inversely proportional to omega, the value of XC will fall. Similarly, if we calculate for low frequencies, then we can see the value of XC will be high. And in the similar manner, what we have studied for an inductor, here we can see at a very high frequency, if we just have a look in this situation, if omega is very high, the value of XC will be tending to zero or negligible. Or we can see this capacitor behaves like almost a short circuit. Or we can say for a very high alternating current, the value of ohmic value or opposition of a capacitor is negligible. And for low frequency, that is almost for DC circuit or at very low frequency variation in current, we can state here if omega is negligible, XC will be excessively high and capacitor behaves like almost as open circuit, which we have studied that in case of DC circuits also where the frequency is zero, there is no variation. The capacitor behaves like open circuit in a steady state. So you must be very careful about both the situations. So here we can write two statements as important notes. You can just write down one for inductor, one for capacitor. For inductor, we can write that an inductor act as short circuit for very low frequency alternating current and act as open circuit for very high frequency alternating current. Similarly, we can write a capacitor act as, in the situation it will be reversed, it will act as open circuit for very low frequency AC and act as short circuit for very high frequency alternating circuit. So, you must be very careful about the use of an inductor and a capacitor at very low or very high frequencies.